Another story we continue to follow. We went back down to Kakaako today, where city crews were wrapping up their sweeps of the homeless in that area. The final phase focusing on the most densely populated area of that encampment near Ohe Street, near the Children's Discovery Center. Well, the hope was to get the homeless into shelters, but clearly not everybody is going and wants to go. We learned some are moving to the nearby Kakaako Waterfront Park. And just like the rest of the area, it's not within the city's jurisdiction. So we wanted to know what's being done to make sure the situation doesn't repeat itself. Alexander Zanes got answers. Alexander.
Thanks, Howard. Even though the city has finished up its sweeps in Kakaako, there's still work to be done. Tents are now popping up in and around the waterfront. So I asked, who's going to keep the area clear?
This morning, city crews were finally finishing up the sweeps of Kakaako Makai. The streets were clear this afternoon, aside from some remnants left behind from the city's homeless sweeps. But the issue remains, some homeless making their way to areas nearby.
Where exactly are all these homeless people that were in the encampment going to go? Well, we already see tents popping up here in Kakaako Waterfront Park. So the question is, what's going to be done about it?
Scott Morishige is the state's homeless coordinator. He told me the state is continuing outreach efforts by coordinating with HCDA.
We're coordinating with them and homeless service providers to make sure that we continue the same type of assertive outreach that we've been doing in Kakaako Makai, where service providers go out there regularly to offer access to shelter and other housing resources.
Morishige says because the park is under HCDA's jurisdiction, it now becomes a matter of enforcing park rules, meaning that if the park is closed, anyone still there will eventually be asked to leave. Some park goers noticed the tents popping up but told me they didn't see a solution.
It's sad. After, you know, I've seen it for 45 years, I've seen every change, and it's sad to see, but that's what it is.
And now I just got a statement from HCDA in an email. HCDA says it's working to ensure services are provided to those who need them while still enforcing park rules. So who enforces those rules? I'm told it's the state sheriffs when they get the call from HCDA. A spokeswoman for the public safety department told me if there are people still in the park after hours, they won't yet be asked to leave. I'll stay on top of this and let you know when the transition from outreach to enforcement is made. Alexander Zanes, KHON 2 News.